Now join Phil Alexander at the bar for a quick fire pub quiz with a difference. Celebrity guests puzzle over musical questions and take up the challenge as we pop down the pub.
And welcome to Pop Down the Pub, the quiz show that drinks where other shows fear to drink. Tonight I'll be joined by two contestants who've agreed to put their pop knowledge to the test. They'll be competing for the ultimate prize in Pint Them, the beautifully crafted Pop Down the Pub tankard. The winner will also get to show their own video. So in the next half hour you can expect some scurrilous video antics, a ton of pop trivia, as well as some seriously ludicrous behaviour. And I don't just mean from me. Here's a taster of what's coming up on tonight's show. Tonight on Pop Down the Pub, we get going with a bit of Ocean Colour Scene. We take in a movie with the Fugees. The Waterboys show us the whole of the moon. And we bring you America's hottest new band, Cold. Now it's time to meet tonight's contestants. Propping up the bar tonight is one-minute silence bass thing, Glen Diani. Glen, originally from Gibraltar, formed the band in London. They have their debut LP, available in all colours, out now.
At last I found people who felt the same way I did, you know. I travelled too many miles to, you know, waste my time. There's 13 songs on the album, you know, it's rap metal and, you know, they're my 13 favourite songs, what can I tell you, you know? By the album.
It's time that we sort of moved over to Paul there. Joining Glen at the bar is Sensor drummer Paul Soden. Back after a three-year absence, Sensor returned with a brand new album, Asylum, and they plan to live on the road.
There's been like a sort of a plan of attack since about November. I've been doing touring around the country, and like starting this year as well, I've just been doing English dates really. We've got DJ that's really into his hip-hop, and I'm really into my dance music. And it's still, I think there's still a fundamentally rock element there, but we'd like definitely use a lot more programming.
Right, so a lot more to come from Sensor. Now it's time for me to actually explain the quiz to you both. It's pretty straightforward. You've got six rounds of pop-filled trivia coming your way. You'll have 10 seconds to answer each question within those rounds. Most of the rounds you'll find will have questions that are linked to videos, and you'll have a multiple choice set of answers, so you can answer either A, B or C. So pretty straightforward, just like playing the trivia machine in your local pub, really. Right, if that's all clear, it's time to take a stroll over to the Pop Down the Pub quiz machine, the lager-fueled pubatron, as we like to call it. Let's take our drinks and off we go, folks. Right, folks, it's time for round one of this quiz now. Before we go any further, though, I'd like you to both shake hands in an act of gentlemanly behaviour. May the best man win, of course. Now, round one is what I like to refer to as the vaguely themed round, purely because there is a vague theme attached to each of the videos that you're going to see. And I'm told that the theme this week is sub-aqua, whatever that means. I presume it means that all the videos you're about to see are related to water in some kind of way. So, without further ado, let's crack on with round one. And on with round one, then. First clip, Ocean Colour Scene, one of your favourites, I can tell there, Glen. This is Traveller's Tune. Stand by, because the questions are coming up now. So, Ocean Colour Scene, managed by Steve Craddock's dad. What was his former profession? Choice of three, hurry up. It's B, he's a policeman, in fact. Right, second question. Hasn't got much personality. What was the lead singer, Simon, talking about at that point? Their debut album. You did used to be good at this, didn't you? Just not when it came to Ocean Colour Scene. Who performed backing vocals on their debut album? Was it Sean Ryder, Alison Moyo or Paul Weller?
So late, I can't really do
it. That was Alison Moyo, actually, which I believe you got right there, actually, Paul. Oh, I'll see if you get on with Aqua, one of your favourite videos ever, isn't it, this, really? It's great. Okay. No. Right?
If I directed the video, it'd be different.
Which country are they from? Very confident on the old AI, aren't you, man? They are from Denmark. Well played there, Glen.
Hey, when it comes to...
Complete this Barbie Girl lyric. Brush your hair. How's it end?
Address me everywhere. Just hope.
You're right again there, Glen. Well played, mate.
Not like the first ones.
Last question on Aqua now. What was the name of Aqua's follow-up single? Was it A, Jungle Gym? Right. B, Dr. Jones? C, Barbie and Ken?
I like that, C.
Not Barbie and Ken, strangely enough. No, it's Dr. Jones. Now, the Water Boys. Well, from before your time, shall we say, Glen. Hollow Moon, it's a bit of a classic track, actually. Not big in Gibraltar, though, I can tell. Is up now. How many times was this track released? Three answers, three options. Well in. The group's fiddler, Steve Wickham, formerly played with which band? Wasn't the Hot House Flowers, I'm afraid, no.
U2,
yeah. Did a bit of fiddling with U2, apparently. Last question on the Water Boys. Carl Wallinger formed another band.
Shame them, Irish.
He formed another band. Who was it? It was Will Party, yes, yes. Well, I think you both got that one right, actually. The first. Last clip in this round, the Beach Boys. Which film was this single featured in? No, it was Cocktail. I mean, Cocktail. A single featured in Cocktail, oh, yes. The band's first four albums had pictures of who on their sleeves? Yes, well done there. I think you both got that one right as well. Well played. Dennis Wilson released a single. Who was actually featured on the B-side of that single? Well, it was Charles Manson. Oh, it was Charles Manson. It wasn't Audrey Hepburn. No, there you go.
I did a good
chance,
Manson. I should have.
And that's the end of round one there, folks. Well, at the end of round one, I can tell you there, folks, that Glen, you're marginally ahead with six. But Paul, you're trailing by just 1 point with five. Now, round two is a pretty straightforward round. It's a point where we ask you who the guest star in these videos actually is. First of all, it's Bruce Springsteen. Who's the guest star in this video? Who dances on stage with Bruce Springsteen in this video for Dancing in the Dark? Is it A, Courtney Cox, B, Jennifer Aniston, or Lisa Kudrow? Yes, it's Courtney Cox. And in fact, here she comes, there she is, Courtney Cox, age 12, clearly.
It's actually Dustin Hoffman.
Right, Paula Abdul, one of your favourites again, Glen. Rush, Rush. Hollywood actor appeared in this video. Who was it? Just later, River Phoenix. Keanu Reeves.
Can I ask you something?
Keanu.
Have you ever been in love?
If I was, I didn't know it. And you?
Remarkable.
Him and John Wayne is
right.
Like...
Have a picture, boys. One for you here, Paul. Clearly one of your favourites, yes. Who appears as Dracula in this video? Peter Cushing, Boris Karloff?
Yeah,
and McClellan.
Yeah.
McClellan.
I thought it was a tennis player.
Here he is. He looks remarkably like the singer.
Now you're gonna tell
me. Looks remarkably like the singer in your band, doesn't he?
Oh, yeah.
Last one in this round is Tracy Ullman. Who makes a guest appearance in this video? They don't know about us. Is it Neil Kinnock, Lenny Henry, or Paul McCartney? Glenn, it wasn't Neil Kinnock. No, Paul, it wasn't Neil. Look, here he is. Here's Macca. Look at that. It's the smallest car he's ever been in his life. And that's the end of round two, I'm afraid, folks. Glen, you are still on six, and Paul, you're still on five. So this is a simple round. This is the vital statistics round. We're going to show you a video by one band. One band. We're going to ask you loads of questions about that one band.
Okay,
now, unfortunately, tonight, the band in question happens to be ABBA. Fantastic jumper, though, by any stretch of the imagination. All right. Which member of ABBA was not Swedish? Björn, Agnetha, or Annie Frid? Glenn, you're not too sure about that, are you?
Oh, yeah.
And you were right, remarkably enough.
I told you, I know a lot about Swedish people.
What was ABBA's only US number one? Three options there, Paul. Tell you, Glenn, you did pretty well there. In fact, you both got that one right. Remarkable, what a turn up for the books that is.
I guess.
Right. Who appeared in the Swedish version of Jesus Christ Superstar? And indeed, can you imagine what that must have been like? Yeah, well, it was Agnetha. Which Swedish company originally used the word ABBA as a trade name? Is it a toilet factory, a car manufacturer, or a fish company? We will see, yeah, there you go, fish company. How many people applied for tickets at see ABBA at the Albert Hall? 76, height of their powers. Well in there, Paul. Yeah. 3.5 million wanted to see it, that's remarkable. Next question. Band were listed as what in 1979 in the Guinness Book of Records? Biggest grossing touring band, biggest record sellers, most hit singles from an album. It was big. Well played there. Who produced Annie Frid's solo album? Was it Lou Reed, Phil Collins, or Ringo Starr? Make it count, come on. It was Phil Collins, actually. So there you go. Yeah. Well, remarkable there at the end of round three. Good behaviour from the pair of you, really. Not the highest scoring round we've ever had, though, I'm sure.
It's better than round two.
It was. Well, at the end of round three, with those crunching tackles going in there, I can actually say that, remarkably enough, you're even Stevens. You're both on 8 points, which is, you know, not too bad at this stage in the game, although not that good, quite clearly. Anyway, it's time for us to take a bit of a beer break and time for everyone at home to check out this brand new video from the hottest band in America. This is Cold. Welcome back to Pop Down the Pub, where if you've just joined us, Glenn from 1 Minute Silence and Paul from Censor are in fact even Stevens on 8 points each as we move into round four, which is the observation round. Great tea coming. Tea's made, right? Always nice to see the boys in drag though, isn't it, really? Freddie had clearly gone stark raving mad by this point in the band's career, I think. I want to break free. He's got good legs, hasn't he? The Merc, as we like to call him.
I think it's just great that they called the band Queen, you know.
Well, I mean, it's not that great, is it, really? It's better than King, I suppose, isn't it?
No, I mean...
I know what you're saying. Yeah. I've got to
break free. The lipstick and the moustache.
I know, good fantastic, look. Yeah. I think Brian is fantastic in this video as well, let's be quite frank.
Oh, actually, it's quite tasty there.
That's really good. My questions are up now. What type of animal slippers does Brian wear in this video? You've gone for a rabbit, and they are rabbit slippers, yes. You've both got that right. What colour are Freddy's earrings? Yellow, pink, blue? Ah, yes. Always a good reason to choose pink, of course. And especially when you're right. newspapers being read in the lounge. It's quite complicated, this one. You have to watch really closely here. There's a Breeder Mirror, the Sun, the Star, Quality Daily. Daily Mirror. What's the time on the tees made then? Sure, you saw the tees made, it's second, though. No, no, it was 8 o'clock. 7:30. What does Brian May get out of the fridge? Now, this is again a very, very tricky question. Have to be watching very closely. Got options: eggs, milk, or bacon. Milk. It was milk. Rubber and Roger in one question. What colour are Roger's gloves?
Marigold.
They're red. I would have gone for marigolds myself. So there you go. Colours of feather dusters on the lounge table. Ah, well, there you go, well played. Yeah. Could have gone either way, couldn't it, at that point? Here are the answers now. Video evidence of what you've just seen. Mirror, of course, there. Teeth made. Milk, which you can just about see. Red gloves. And there you go, and that brings us to the end of round four there. So without further ado, let's move on to round five. Lovely boy's own. Big favourite, isn't it, this one?
Yeah.
Big favourite. Big favourite with your singer, who's from Ireland.
Can you say suck on television?
You can say suck.
Suck.
You can say suck, yes. Who recorded the original of Words? Is it Leo Sayer, the Commodores, or the Bee Gees?
It's Leo Sayer.
Leo Sayer. It's the Bee Gees, of course. Leo Sayer. I have a word with myself.
Bee Gees.
It's like a Caffrey's advert, isn't it, this? Right, onto Wet, Wet, Wet. With a little help from my friends. Big fans of yours, though. They like 1 Minute Silence, but Wet. Marty Pello's a big fan. Some coming to all your gigs, isn't it?
Right.
Stand by for the old question. Who recorded the original version of this Wet, Wet, Wet hit? Now, of course, there was a band before this person in particular. Yeah, there you go. Joe Cocker. Smug and rather confident there, if you don't mind the same thing, Glen. You're a bit smug and confident in that. Simple pressing button
there.
Yeah,
that'll help from.
Could it be magic? Take that. Would you like to use the word suck at this point, or perhaps later in the
I just wonder it's not allowed, actually.
Right, right, on a family show like this.
Yeah. I'd put
mind you, I mean, they really do look like fine pilchards.
I put them on the Titanic with
anyway,
them.
Anyway, who recorded the original version of Could It Be Magic? Was it Jason Donovan, Donna Summer, or Buck Spears? Oh, yes, Donna Summer it was. Now, she must have enjoyed this version. On to the Fugees. We're looking quite confident at this stage in the game. Who recorded the original version of Killing Me Softly? Paul, you've gone for Roberta Flack. Glenn, you've gone for Aretha Franklin. And of course, Paul, you are right. Well played. Robbie Williams with Freedom. He's another one for the Titanic.
Yes. Yeah, MC Hammer. Kennedy.
Sadly, we can't refloat the Titanic, but we can ask you this question. Bobby covered this George Michael hit in which year? It was 96.
See you, Bobby.
Yes, that's the last question on round five there, and that brings us to the end of the round. So there we go. Well, as we approach the last round, round six, I can tell you now, Glenn, you're trailing by 14 points to Paul's mighty 16. So there's everything to play for, though, because it really is only 2 points in it. And this is the quickfire round, which either makes or breaks your attempt to win the Pop Down the Pub tankard. So onwards with round six. You won't see any videos. You'll just get a load of questions flying at you. Here they come.
Okay.
First question. What job did Cyndi Lauper undertake in the late 80s? Show us a three there. female wrestling manager, bunny girl, restaurant owner. Yes, she was a female wrestling manager. Who would have thought it? The question, what was the name of Mick Hucknall's punk band? It was the Frantic Elevators.
Maybe Mickey and the Mice.
What was Shakespeare's sister named after? Go walk and play, Smith's song. A cartoon character. A Smith song. With its Snoop Doggy Dogg begin his musical career. Well played.
Hey.
It doesn't really affect me.
Doesn't really affect me. What is Louise Wiener talking about? You'll hear the answer in just a second as well. It is criticism.
It doesn't really affect me at all. And there are times when you read something really horrible about yourself and you just think, oh, God.
Drugs have affected her, though, and so have alcohol. So, there you go. Right, a suede question now. How old was Richard Oakes when he replaced Bernard Butler in Suede? He was 17 years old, in fact.
Can I get 3 points for that question?
No, you can't. You can't get 3 points, no. Who wrote Justify My Love for Madonna? Was it Alanis Morissette, The Crab, or George Michael?
Lenny
Crab.
I knew that one.
A horrible man, he actually is, really. Anyway, which songwriter was the song Killing Me Softly written about? John Lennon, rather unfortunate. Neil Sedaka, or Marvin Gaye, more unfortunate. Neil Sedaka there. He produced a volume of poetry entitled Songs for While I'm Away. For Phil, Mark, or Jim? It had to be Phil. He was away a lot. Who said, women get all excited about nothing, then they marry him. No, it's not HB there, unfortunately, Glenn. Right, who organises Buddy Holly Week every year? I presume that means around their house or something, because I'm not too au fait of events around Buddy Holly Week myself. It is Paul McCartney. Right, the last question in this round, this annual Brighton round, which group were fined for urinating against a London petrol station? Was it the Jam, the Clash, or the Stones? It was the Clash. All right, and that brings us to the end of round six. Well, at the end of that nail-biting sixth round, I can actually tell you that, Glenn, sadly, you are tonight's loser with 18 points, but your metal credibility remains intact. But tonight, Paul, you're the winner. You win the beautifully crafted Pop Down the Pub with a staggering 22 points there.
Thank you very much.
Feel the quality on that.
Fantastic.
Couldn't get that, you know, couldn't get that down the market, could you? No, there you go. Still, you also get the chance to show your video. So, have you got a brand new video for us?
Yeah, we've got a video for the new single, Breed.
Right. Time for us to have a look at that, I think.
Hope so.
Yeah. All it remains for me to say is thanks to the pair of you for popping down the pub.
That's right.
Cheers, man. That's right.
Good to see there's no animosity or hard feelings, but hopefully you'll nut each other outside. Yeah, good one. Anyway, to everyone at home, thanks a lot for watching. We'll see you same time, same place next week when we pop down the pub once again. We'll leave you with a bit of Censor right now. Till next week, it's your round.